preparing to shut down their plants there. This is, of course, on the heels of the same thing happening in the United States between China, Brazil, and the U.S. Those are the world's biggest producers of meat. And so when you see them shutting down, this is... I don't even have words at this point. We've been talking about a global protein shortage even before 2020 busted on the scene and caused all these issues. So where we are now is just unthinkable. And, you know, I've been talking about this effort to link this dirty way of doing things, the farms and the ranches and the meat. It's all dirty. It's all ridden with viruses and pandemics, and it's causing human death. Now we're actually seeing that narrative be deployed. Here is a store from southern Germany. It's Aldi Süd, with a sign posted on the door. I actually contacted a professional German translator to make sure that I got this right, because I'm not messing around here, folks. Corona information distributed by the southern German branch of Aldi says, quote, meat, dairy, and egg consumption make pandemics more likely. There it is. There's the fat finger of blame being pointed at the old, dirty way of growing food, of producing meat, even eggs. You see that the blame is being pegged squarely on food production. Never mind the fact that Fauci was funding this research and then shipped it to China when it was illegal. It's all absurd. Again, quote, continuing, 80% of pandemics have their origin in the animal industry. The industrial factory farming is the ideal breeding ground for new pathogens. Epidemics benefit from the rising number of livestock. So, to reduce the likelihood of future pandemics, the consumption of animal products needs to be reduced drastically. And then they put it on you. You're going to have to change your diet. Just like the UN IPCC land use report said last year, we're going to have to force people to change their diet. Don't know how we're going to do it. This is how. You can reduce the risk of a next pandemic by eating plant-based foods. In German, it's like plantly food. They don't even really have a word for it. It's a very Americanism coming in there. We thus ask you, in this last line, we thus ask you to abstain from animal products. Direct request to the consumer, stop eating animal products. It's unbelievable. It's unbelievable. Now, this grocery store could just as easily solve this problem by not buying from the disgusting factory farms that are doing these, that they have themselves have created. These big companies have bought up and consolidated all the good factory, all the good family farms, all the nice ranchers have been consolidated and bought up over the years into JBS, into Tyson, and it was they who created this Frankenstein, disgusting, nasty factory farming model in the first place. We should shut down those people. But no, it's you. You have to change what you're doing, because we couldn't possibly figure out how to instead source our meat from, you know, Gabe Brown or other regenerative practitioners that are actually doing things the right way. No. We can't buy meat from them. We're only buying it from the factory farms, which means you have to change your diet. You see how ridiculous this is? And I hope it's now clear, if you had any doubt about what I was making that claim before, that they are going to pivot this whole narrative and say pandemics are because of meat and you need to stop eating it. Now it's right here in your face. We thus ask you to stop eating meat.